All right, now I'm here, finally. So I have to check some things before I go into the game. Show location on the map. Toggle head bob. Toggle new goals. I don't think I want this on. Control invert Y axis, sure. Like more sound other than the voice and the music. All right. Everything safe? Cool. All right. It's Firewatch. I'm thinking not going like I do with Mega Man, that I play all the whole game in one sitting. I'm going to try to play at this one like in three or four different streams. So, gonna go like for an hour and a half today, and then I'll continue in another day. All right. Thanks, Slims. I'll try. I was super excited about this game, you know, but then, you know, reviews started saying like, oh, it's not so great. I mean, there's something good, but not everything is it should be. And I was expecting to have more freedom to explore and all and go all the way, you know, explore everywhere, but some people say that it's like a freaking huge hallway, and that's about it. Which is a bit sad. I don't know. Oh well. You see Julia. Okay. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing, well dressed. Professor and grad student from the University of Boulder. You, Henry, are drinking with your pals. Do you approach her? Okay. I approach her. I am drunk. I'm not drunk right now, come on. So, what's your, you know, major? You're pretty. Eh, that would go with the first one. Is that the word? I was like, Coors. Oh, come on, I don't drink Coors. I'm better than this. Given our evolutionary biology, he says. I'm a professor. Cool, you reply. What's your, she asks. She sniffs the air. Toxicology? Was that a porn, you ask? She says, definitely. Where did she hurt your feelings? She asks if you want to split a cheeseburger. 1 week later, you're Julie's boyfriend. Oh, so freaking cute. I am role-playing as myself. I am the depressed guy. R2 to use objects. All right. Oh wow, this guy is freaking slow. Get my backpack. Is it weird? All right, what can I do? Just walk around? Oh, I can run actually. Zoom with L1 or okay. Run, Henry. Run. Guess it's not. Is it weird? I don't think it's weird. I mean, it's different. Ooh, look, Jag is here in this wall. Jag is. Guess I was going the wrong way. What other games have you played, John? Live forever here. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. Oh. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Seriously? Life is good. Yuli wants to get a dog. Okay, later. I like dogs. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Yuli is in love. She wants to bring it into her class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German Shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Yuli while walking this dog. It's badass. I don't like German Shepherds, so I'll go with the beagle. Bucket. Seriously? Bucket's a good dog, and a week later, you've totally forgotten about the other one. Yuli loves him. You love him too. Oh. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer 9:30 p.m. and this heat still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Cerveza's buena? Cerveza's good. I mean, I don't mind beer. But dude, there are many, many more drinks than just beer. And this asshole drinks Coors, so... Really? Coors? No offense, if you like Coors, but... So what do you think about kids? She asks. Ooh, kids? They're not very smart or good at much. I'm sorry if you and I have some, a couple little idiots. Ooh, ooh. That's true. Maybe Coors could have sucked less in 1979. Maybe. That would be pretty good, I said awkwardly. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, we'll like that, you say. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best their parents are hitched. You say she's absolutely right. Eh, I guess. Explore the park. Whee! Our danger? Ooh, hi. Look at that. Uh-oh. This is not good. It's funny, I packed my bags here. But when I got off the car, I'm already wearing it. Stupid games and continuity. Third offer, Trailhead. Oh, look at two forks. Region overview. To thoroughfare local, Beartooth Point. Produced by the United States Geological Survey. Eh. Do not forget to check in. You're in their country. Prepare my son to come out for exploring hikers. No fireworks, okay, kids? You're a bee snob? Me too, don't worry. Da-da-da-da. 1980. It's a Thursday night and Julie is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angry by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. Oh no, this ain't good. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You get mad, you ignore her. Really? Oof. Wow. I can ignore, right? I don't know. Eeny, meeny, miny, moo. You don't touch each other all night. The next day you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She says it was great. You hold onto a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. I choose MASH! No, I'm not Karin. Sorry. I'm Henry. 1981. Julie still likes to draw. She draws plans for her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. You pose and flex like He-Man. He-Man. You're frolic like a Victoria's Secret model. Yeah, we go for He-Man. You look awesome. Seriously. Music in this game. That piano track is really relaxing and thought provoking. Man, this game is beautiful. I don't get mad too often, so I don't think I would. It would have been like kind of thing to get mad. Like a damn bird. Damn it! To climb over extractions. In 1982. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking bucket at night. The duck's still alive? There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Ooh. Ooh. Bucket gets kicked. Fuck, duck, Julie yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she's stressed. You confront the attacker. You scare him away. You beat his goddamn face in. I think, yeah, I could go for this one. Depends on how enraged I am. Your arms get cut up, but you beat up the gate to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry your eyes before the cops show up. Yulia asks to take a different path. You say, okay, you don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. I thought when she was saying to take a different path, it's like she wanted a divorce. Not going for a different path, like a, you know, a real path. Beat his goddamn face, of course! He deserved it, he kicked my dog! Should have kicked him, but pulled. ...1984. Plans to have kids get way late by work. Yeah, she talked about kids back in 1979 or something. It's been 5 years already. Julia gets offered a job at jail. Jail is in Connecticut. It's a great job. Associate Department Chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Can we ask her to not to take the job? I agree if she... I wouldn't be that much of an ass. I agree, but commuting back and forth 2,000 miles is not actually great. Yeah, it is. Suck up and move, of course. I would suck it up and move. And I would love to go to Connecticut. Oh well. You know John? Huh. Oh well. I guess I'll go with the second one. It's a stupid. Long-term relationships don't work. I fact. You don't want. Now, you ask if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her not to pass it up. If she, it's what she wants. She agrees, she flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. Dude, that's going to kill this stuff. What if the job's in Florida? Depends. Well, no, I wouldn't come to Florida. Yeah. 1985, Julie sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. Ooh. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. Whoa. She was found crying in the stairwell. You say that maybe guys should take the... Talk to someone about it. You take macaroni and drink wine. See, now he's drinking wine. That's better. And not forget about it. You cannot forget about stuff like this. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they're worried that Julia may be suffering from early onset dementia. Oh, great. She's... Hey, I'm Florida, man. I'm cool, I think. I cannot move. Why? Just look around. Journal, pick up. He man. Oh, but it was a naked picture. Oh lord. Oh lord. Yeah, don't worry, Wolf. I should have said that of course there are going to be spoilers in this game. Because it's like a story-driven game, so if you don't want to, you know, hold yourself, hop up. Bucket's getting older. Julie comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. That's true. All dogs are better. A week later, she goes back to the university. Woo. Some nudes. Julie's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on a permanent... Oh, damn, this game is depressing as hell. Thanks, Wolf. See you around. Some days you get the Julia who calls you a dope and unborn children little idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. Eesh. You tell her family, they're crushed and begin to make trips and from their home in Australia to visit her. Eesh, she's from Australia? So you should have spoke with an accent back then, but oh well. For a while, your friends come by on little things, with little things to brighten her the day. She gets worse. Oh, 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care at home. It sits with you for a couple of months. I'll go for the second one. That's me. Determined to take him out. Yeah, of course. It's closed my path back. Let's move this way. Ooh, an animal. Hey there. It's impossibly hard. The worst is when you get mad at her, like she, when she tries to cook her own food. You can do anything without you can do anything without you. See? There. When she goes to sleep, you stay up for a few hours, drinking on the deck, watching baseball in the summer, college baseball, basketball in the winter. Drinking then too. I'm not an alcoholic, sorry. Don't think wrong of me or anything. You start going out after you put her to bed. The first time you do it, you worry about her getting up and walking around while you're gone. You put a chair in front of the bedroom door. Really? What if she goes into a panic attack? It'll be worse. You trust that she sleeps like a rock. Yeah, yes. You go to the same bar as at the boring end of Pearl Street. It's nice there. Over time, you tell Sheila, the bartender, everything. It's a huge weight off. You're home and in bed by 1 a.m. a couple nights a week. You look forward to those nights. 19? One night you're stopped at a DUI checkpoint. You blow up 0.10 and are taken to jail for the night. You consider trying to hide it, but you tell your sister-in-law, Susan. Your parents take the next plane from Australia. They can't leave, they stay your house is in. Then they tell you Julie's coming to live with them. You don't argue. You'll say you'll visit soon. A few weeks go by. Summer is coming and you see an ad in the paper for a job.
You take it. I can barely read it, but it says you take it. Put in.
Yay, my journey begins by me not going to the place I'm supposed to go to. Or maybe I'm supposed to go this way. I don't care. I'm going to explore. Let's run. Start a fire? I will do it. Hey Cluj, how are ya? Oof, I hear something. What's that? Probably nothing. Oh, thank you PlayStation for giving me stuff I don't need to read. Start a fire, then you can Firewatch. Of course. Ooh, I can go into the water. What does it say? We need a key. Damn it. Man. Of course. Well, I guess I'll go back to the tower. Ooh, what? What? Some message. What was it? Fire! No, not yet. There's... Okay, let's go back. I'm doing nothing here. So what year is it? Is it again 1987? 1980 something, right? Just give me a minute, gotta check some messages. Alright, let's go back to the tower. Tower. Ooh. Pop in, pop out, pop in, pop out, pop in. Does it happen here? No. Here? No. Just here. Pop in, pop out. Ooh, there's a restroom. Why does he walk like an action figure? Look at him wobble his arms like that. Here. Stupid Henry, pretending to be He-Man in the nude. Generator, outhouse. I wouldn't pick that baseball. Should I? Okay. Salmon. It's probably covering poop. Drop it where it belongs. Not there, you idiot. There. Ugh. There you go. Where it belongs. Wooden sign. Pick it up. Hey. So freaking creepy. Let's move it. Uh-oh, sorry. Come here. Put you in here. Oh, come on. Stand up. I should take a picture of this. Sorry. It's sticking out. Alright, let's go back to the tower. Sorry. Hop over. Ooh, what's that? A third of her lookout. Is there any other lookouts around here? No, just that one. Okay. Shadow Moses Tower. Oh.
I can see something inside. Red light.
Ooh, red light. Okay, I guess they're broken. Damn it. Oh. Silly me. Yay.
Hello, Two Forks Tower. Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Wait, I gotta check my place. Cookbook. Huh? Damn it! Stop it!
Hello, Two Forks, come back. Pick up your radio.
Jonas Alert. I need light to read. Damn it. Delilah?
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Don't mind your mind alone. You don't know me.
But 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Is that it?
Close?
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job.
Ooh. Day one. Walking simulator. Yeah, that's what I've been saying. Like, some people love him and some people like hate it. I mean, whatever. I really wanted to give it a try.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Dude, stop stalking me. Not cool. Sorry, I guess I slept in.
Hey, sorry, I guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep?
Yeah, Jesus, this is what, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it, that hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Yep.
see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing, you use this to, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your
please.
Window, are you seeing what I'm seeing?
What?
Are those fucking fireworks?
Fireworks? Where?
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Where?
Seriously, are you seeing this?
No. What? Oh, fireworks. Yeah, I see them now.
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight.
Like, kick the shit out of them? Can I write them a ticket? I'm really
nervous. Can you handle that?
Like, kick the shit out of him, sort of straight?
No. Jesus, no.
What? I'm not a cop. It's not like I've got a rule book over here.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
Alright, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich.
Oh, come on.
You probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake.
They call me Knuckles.
Right.
Unlike Sonic, I don't chuckle. Okay.
Convenient.
That's one word for it.
Okay, I'm done. Can I pick the bleach and drink it? Chlorid sucks. Pinecone. Examine the pinecone. Throw it! I should cook it. Come on. Freaking idiot. Come on. Drink it, pansy. The frying pan? Yeah, I should. I can't. Grab it. I should be able to, but I can't. Look, it says fire. I'm watching the fire. That's it. Game done. Good night. Dig it. Broken clock. Great. Good end. Yep. Best end. A fuck up simulator? Yeah, probably. Who knows? Old Scottish oil soap. Glass cleaner. Ooh, more books. They appear overnight. Because they were not here when I went to sleep. Birds of Wyoming. Cool. George Sinclair. Okay, I'm cool. Seriously? Just drop it, don't throw it. Yeah, better. What's this? Death strikes at 2. By Richard Sargent. Okay, cool. And this one? The Patriots. Donald Anderson. Isn't that the name of the DARPA chief, right? Right, Klug? It was the name of the DARPA chief in Metal Gear Solid. Pretty sure. Okay, go back. Donald Anderson. What's this? Bookshelving simulator. Yep, best game ever. This look cheap. There you go. Yeah, isn't that the name of the DARPA chief, Donald Anderson, right? And the book is called The Patriots. See? Donald Anderson. Ooh. Manly? Really? Manly? Oh, well. Ha! Manly. My ass. Calendar? 1989. Get in bed, I'll join you there. In a bit. I want to play. Flowers. Cross the streams. Wink, wink. Terrible. Gonna break his arm. Okay. Call the kids. Oh. Yeah, that's a bad idea, having this thing here. Huh. Run, 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 fool. Fire wrapping NFSK, cash box 306. Cash box 306. Where is it? Oh, there you go. 308, 309, 307, 306. Two forks lookout. So it's slightly northwest. Okay. West, northwest. This way. I don't need that, my manly thermos. I'm manly enough without. Not much, I just... Oh, well, what Kluge said. Just that. Okay, I'll go back for my manly thermos. Damn it. The tower. Ah, there it is. With urine. All right, let's go. Still carrying this, but I cannot run when I'm carrying a thermos. Oh no, I can run. Look. Perfect. Where was... Oh. The... Man, don't run. Oh, look. It's still in here. I love this. Gonna take another picture. My thermos. No, there's a baseball in the toilet. Look. there is. Old baseball. I put it in there. Ooh, my thermos. Where is it? Oh. Okay. Let's put it there. That is a baseball. What? Ugh. There you go. I should put this guy in the tower to pretend I'm working, right? Come here. Let's go. The long dark? I've heard about it. But I think I'm going to buy... what's the name? Life is Strange, I found, it's right now on sale, so I might buy that one next. Goodbye, Manly Termo. Yeah, goodbye. See you around. Never liked ya. Haha. Alright, where do I put him? Where's the tower? The other watchtower. There it is. Going to pretend I'm reading my books here. Okay. Come on. Ugh.
Yeah, I don't think there's any fictional character I hate more than Forrest Burns.
Henry, as an employee of the Forest Service, that is treason.
Yeah, well, he really freaked me out as a kid.
He inspired me to spend the bulk of my 30s keeping the wilderness safe.
A shrink would have a field day with you.
Thanks, Mom.
What kind of name is Forrest Burns, anyway?
Well, that would be a pun, Hank. A glorious pun.
Forrest Burns.
I hired a guy named Royal Butts.
Royal?
Butts.
I didn't think anyone had been named Royal since the 1850s.
Well, Royal's mom, Flo, was a bit of a trendsetter.
Flo Butts? Oh, man, that's even worse.
Yeah, well, it's still better than Forrest Burns.
Come on, just stand up, fool. Just pretend you're working. Ugh. Another sturgeon book. Someone likes that guy, I guess. Come on, Forrest. Come on, stand up. Ugh. Yeah, Ferbs, Life is Strange is on sale for PlayStation 4 right now. Well, for PlayStation Plus members only. All right, so I had to go. West, north, this way. Nagi supervisor. She has a name. I don't know her name, but she has a name. Come on. Also, there are many games on sales. You should check them all. I can't remember. I think Hotline Miami 2 was also on sale. Half right. Yeah, half the price. Naggy supervisor. Yep. I'll finish this quest, the fireworks quest, and then I'll stop playing. Supply cash. Oh, these are yeah, that's true. Oh, the passcode was 1234, right? Cash 3OC to 2-4 lookout. Hey man, guy couldn't take it, so I locked in his lookout and put some stuff in the box. Found one of those bars you liked. Hiking into the. Let's get fogging and big. Okay. Old rope.
Track down that rope. It was right where you said.
Great. So you should be set to get down to the lake.
Well, hey, got a rope. Granola bar.
Hey, there's a snack in here. Probably gonna eat it.
You definitely do not want to do that. Whatever's in there has been in there for years. That's how you get food poisoning.
It says it's fine. I'm picking it up. Eat it.
Some guy Dave?
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Harmless, but yeah. One of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type? Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
Do people lose their shit doing this job? There's a note that says a guy just left his post.
It happens, yeah. You're not gonna pop your top, are you, Henry?
I wasn't planning on it.
Nice. Okay, let's go. So where were those fireworks again? Yeah. Cash 306. Medicine whale. Two forks lookout. Virtus lookout. Oh well, I think it's this way. I can remember where the fireworks were. Where is it? I think it's this way. Join to the lake to the west. This way. I think Jonesy Lake was where I was earlier, right? Oh, there's nothing in here. Wait, did I just... Yeah, I was here. Damn it, I'm lost already. Well, let's keep going. I think I heard something here. Nah. Okay.
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat. People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting?
No, Henry, that's life.
Christ, lady.
Getting closer. Where are they coming from, though? There you go.
This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
Yeah, well, I'd go with Widowmaker.
Come on, it's really not that bad.
It's a 50-foot cliff made of rocks that look like knives.
They just look like knives, okay? Plus, there's already a Widowmaker on the backside of Carter Mountain. It would be confusing.
All right, don't spoil. But I guess everyone dies in the end, right? Or either that or it's on the nanomachines. Because it's always nanomachines. Look. Flunk. That wasn't good. I probably set the fire. Ow.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Widowmaker got the best of me.
What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Be careful for Christ's sake.
All right. Hey Kelsey, what's up? Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Port Meadow.
Wow, there's a big rock outcropping down here near the lake. It's really something.
Yeah, makes for good camping. There used to be a group of guys who would boulder out there a couple times a year.
What happened to them?
Dunno. Just stopped coming out.
No, I don't need to ask for help yet. Investigate.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans, they threw them all over hell.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. Just found where they're hanging out.
Da-da-da-da-da. Let's walk down this way. Ooh. Found something.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't count just plain stupid, does it?
Ooh, she's nagging again. Naggy. Ooh. Fairy, what? Fairytale Irish single malt. Ech. Cheap.
You left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
See?
What? You don't like a cold Moscow light on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than some fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure. You know what? Fuck it, I'm not the mate.
Did I just drink that? No, clean up. Okay. Yeah, I cannot drink it. Save it for later. Hey! Cool. I'll save it for later. Magic missile? Fire wheel! Confiscate. Bitches. Backpacks?
They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Damn it. Alright. Skinny dip, these bitches. You should steal their clothes.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
Real classy. Why did he drop it?
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
Yeah, they're going to regret it. Are they listening to Madonna? Oh my, it gets more interesting here. Seriously? Why did you stop?
There are panties.
There are what?
What?
I won't say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
Oh snap. I am a 12 kid boy. A bra. Oh, more bras.
There's a
yes.
There are two naked women. Forget it.
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies, same as anyone, but there's, you know. Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay.
sneak up.
I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Enjoy dealing with that.
Well, they show earlier an illustration of the guy naked, like a drawing of the protagonist. So maybe, I don't know, this game is not teens, they're drunk. No, not yet. Ooh, I'm gonna steal the boombox, bitches. I'm running away with the stereo. They couldn't find son. I hope they drown.
Well, look, if you can hear me, try to get back soon, okay? It's getting late.
So there's no noise ordinances or rules out here?
No, but that music I hear makes a good case for them.
Yeah, no kidding.
Gonna throw it in a lake. Fools. Oh, they're gone.
Well, this lake does seem like a good spot to swim, and if the last people to do so were assholes.
Yeah, right now, though, it's all snowmelt, so you'll freeze your balls off. But, maybe that's a fair trade.
Starting to feel like it. Chance of those kids getting a disease in this lake, like diphtheria or consumption?
Consumption? Not if they're not 19th century chimney sweeps, no.
You know, whatever.
I mean, if they drank a bunch, Giardia maybe, but probably not this time of year.
That's too bad.
That boombox deserved to be drowned.
Hey, there's a trail to Two Forks Tower down here near the lake.
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Climbing back up that slide.
Whatever, Nagy. Careful. No, they're gone. Apparently, stealing their radio made them disappear. See? No one in the lake. Oh well. Let's go back to the station. Yeah, fire may have to do something with this, I guess. Climb up. Really? Did Markiplier said that, or did the game said that? This is a nice place. Oh, the game. Oh well. Now that I shouldn't have dropped that radio, that boombox. Damn it! Now I need music.
confession make.
Confession?
What is it?
I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
I already ate the granola bar. So I'm good with food. The year old granola bar. Climb up. 20-year-old? Damn. The thing was rancid then. I'm not going to feel good tonight. Uh-oh.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning.
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home and try not to get hit by lightning.
It's okay.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide, would you believe?
Oh, great. Canyon, Two Forks Lookout, right Birdtooth Point.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
So
I say, fuck it. You're a grown man. You can go where you want.
Great.
Yay!
Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. She loved it. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa. Oh, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it.
Hello?
like the path leads through the cave.
Back in the cave, huh? Man, I don't need to lose another lookout in there.
Another lookout?
They go in. They never come out.
So this is another one of your jokes.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
I bless the rains down in Africa!
Oh, he's sad.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Ah, damn.
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your kidney kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, oh, sorry, Hank.
I'm gonna go back from where I came from. Where's my tower? Lost. Damn it. I don't think it's this way. I'll trudge on though. No, seriously, stop the meowing. For now, I guess. Where was the cave again? This way? Yeah, this way. Good. Let's go.
Some guy out here.
Some guy? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
Freaking stalkers. Gotta jump. Climbing up the mountain. Climbing up the mountain. Hey, Delilah.
Hey, you keep your lights on at night.
Crosswords.
Puzzles.
Climbing up the rocks. All right, John, see you around. I'm almost done with this stream, so whoop. So as I was saying, almost done.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the black path. It was backbreaking, but you know, anything for the service.
Thank you.
Anytime.
Oh, there's a tower.
So it's just the outhouse then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want.
Well, yay. Please have some decency.
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground outside of my tower. Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell?
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
Ooh, intense music. Something's happening.
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker.
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
I'm gonna have to fix the window.
Tomorrow, Henry, you won't be cold.
Yeah, I found a cardboard guy. I moved him around and now he's in the tower. Or maybe he's not in the tower.
Okay, thanks.
Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts. Great.
See?
Okay.
Here he is.
In the morning I'm gonna
Curious.
They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to
protect
it.
Me.
See if anything comes up.
Thanks.
For me.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I've done it before.
Okay, tough guy.
All right, I'm done for tonight. Thanks everyone for coming, and I'll probably be streaming this again tomorrow at the same time of the day, if not tomorrow, at least on Thursday. Everyone for coming. Good night. Have a great one.